What a lovely place. It's really nice here. And I also had to find a nice place, because the question I will try to answer is actually a complicated one, and the easiest one ever. But it is a really common question, and many artists are confronted with this question. And I, even that I know actually the answers, I am also having this kind of question very often. It is the question, how do I price my art? What is the price tag? What is the right place to ask for a certain price for your art? And to answer this question, I will do it show you different possibilities how you can actually answer this question, because it is something that is really important to the progression actually of your art. The decisions you are making with your price tag have influence later on your art career, and perhaps selling your art, taking the opportunity to sell your art for whatever price it is very often not the right decision. When you are looking what successful artists are doing in the market, they are actually very careful how they are pricing their art, and in many times you will not find immediately a price tag on the art piece, but you are going to someone like a gallerist or an art agent to find out the list price for a certain artwork, and there is a certain reason for this. But first, let me get rid of a certain myth about pricing art. Pricing art is something that should never happen by default. It is something that you should always be very careful about and choose it with the right strategy. Because taking it in default or let someone else make the decision about your artwork can influence you artistic progression in a great way. So whatever you are doing about your right price, never let it happen by default or just through the situation. And the reason for this is that actually the way you are building your prices in the market will make it obvious your value in the art market. We will come later to this, but first, the first method that I want to introduce to you, especially in the beginning, how to price your art, is really something that is based on your realistic circumstances. Nevertheless, to even have a chance to progress as an artist, you must survive as an artist. Most likely in the beginning, art is not what you are doing as a profession, but you have most likely a job or other possibility of income that is supporting your artistic you as an artist, so you can create art. And the first mistake that you should avoid, that because you have another income sources, you can put the price of your art very low. And the problem with this is actually when you are beginning to get successful with this approach, because suddenly you have an income as an artist, but actually what you are getting for your art will never be enough that you actually can survive as an artist, because you had as a second income source. Even when you are saying, okay, but now when I don't have to have the second job, I can produce more art, but then you are going in quantity, not quality, and this will make your life really difficult as an artist. So the first approach that you should use is the realistic one. It is really easy. You are putting all your expenses together. So your art materials, perhaps you have already a studio, so the rent for the studio, electricity and so on, and your other life's expenses, like your food, the clothing that you are having. So in the end, you are figuring out what is your monthly expense. This is what you must have that you will survive. And the second step of it is really easy. Then you are figuring out per month how many artworks are you producing, or you are able to produce. It's better to take an optimistic number, like, oh, I will produce 6 artworks every month, and then you are taking a pessimistic number, like, okay, it will come down to 1 or 2, and then it is a number in the between that is realistic. But let's, in this this example, let's keep it really pessimistic. So you are producing only 1 artwork every month, and all you have to do now is to take your expenses, your materials, your rent and so on, all those expenses, and divide it to the amount of artworks you are producing. So when you are producing 6 artworks, it's your expenses divided through 6. And in this example, let's take it, you are only producing 1 artwork, so your whole monthly expenses must come through this one sale of her artwork. So there you have it, your whole monthly expenses must come through the 1 artwork that you are producing. There you have your price. This would be the easiest way to price actually your art. But there's an extension to this method that is making it is even more realistic. It is actually to extend the thinking about how high is the probability of selling your art. Now you have made perhaps some experience in the art market, so you actually know that you are selling perhaps 1 of 10 of your artworks, you are selling 1 of 5 of your artworks, and so on. So you can say actually how high is the probability that during 1 month you are able to sell 1 artwork. So let's say the probability, because we are always pessimistic, is not very high, you are able to sell 1 of 5 artworks. So most likely in this month, it is a chance of 1 to 5 that you will actually sell your artwork. But then you nevertheless, you have the monthly expenses. What will you do? Then to be able to not get broke in this month, all you have to do is take the probability of selling your art 1 to 5 and multiply it with the price of her artwork. So in the beginning, let's say you need $1,000 for your life expenses, you are producing 1 artwork, so the 1 artwork would be costing $1,000, but you have a probability 1 to 5 to sell this artwork. So you take this price for the artworks and you are multiplying it with 5. So now your artwork is costing $5,000 because your probability of selling art is so low, and nevertheless you have to you have all the expenses every month. So with this calculation you are actually on the safe side of selling your art. This is, I think, a very reasonable approach to pricing your art, because it is about you surviving as an artist. And very often to be able to survive as an artist is the most important thing actually. But even this approach is very short-sighted. It has nothing to do with developing actually art career, and this is why I want to show you a second approach that will give you actually orientation. What is your market value right now? Where are you in the market, and how to price your art in this market hierarchy? And actually, why is it so that some artists are having such huge prices for their art? To explain it to it, I will show you a graphic. I hope you can see it. And this is the simplest simplification of the market levels that are actually. It is the starter market, where you are at beginner, the primary market, when you are a little bit more advanced, there is an interaction with galleries, and then the secondary market, when you are a market professional. And whatever you are doing with your pricing of your art, it is important that in the end you can end up in the secondary market, so you are not building prices that are unable to sustain your path in this market. So let me begin. When you are in the starter market, this is an easy exchange of values. This means you are having the value of your art and you are selling it to an art buyer, and to be realistic. All it takes is actually to get so much from the art buyer that you can just survive. And this is it about the starter market. This is you about you being alive in the art market and staying creative and being able to produce actually art. And many artists are deciding to stay right there. It has nothing to do with actually expanding you as an artist because you are getting in the secondary market. It has sometimes not so much to say about the quality of the art. It is saying about the quality of your market progression. That's it. But nevertheless, once you have decided to progress in the market, you can begin to the semi-professional league, the primary market. So between you and the person who is buying art, there's an intermediary, someone that is helping actually selling you art, like a gallerist, an agent. There are many possibilities. And nevertheless, this person in between must earn some money too. So to your art price, there's a kind of extra money that should go into this art that the art buyer in the end must pay so the gallerist can survive and can uphold his business. So the art price that you are having is now increased by 20, 60 or even sometimes 80%. So that's why the price of the art is increasing so much. And now comes the problem. When you have been very cheap in the starter market, it is a problem why your art that was costing before, let's say, $5,000, now 80% extra because this intermediary in between. Imagine this, what a price increase it is. And nevertheless, the art buyer is making, checking it, and he's seeing, okay, the prices of your art 2 years before were $5,000, and now it is an increase of prices of 80%. And then the art buyer will ask himself, is there an increase of your art quality, of your art value? Yes or no? And the problem is then suddenly there's an increase of price without really increase of the value of the art. So the art buyer is not thinking actually he's making a good deal. And when you are setting your price in the beginning, the starter market, in the beginning very high, and now you are going to the secondary market, you are able to explain the higher prices because perhaps for yourself you are lowering what you are getting out of the deal, but nevertheless a art agent, a gallerist can accompany you, your sales. So you have in the starter market, you have developed a capacity in the price so someone else can actually help you and do his work without increasing the price value as a whole. And then we are moving on to the secondary market, and then everything is actually changing. You are not selling only, not anymore to the end buyer anymore, and there is not only one intermediary in between like a gallerist, but your art is going into a whole cycle of selling and buying and so on. So perhaps you are selling first your art to a gallerist. From this gallery, the art is perhaps sold to an art auction, an art collector, and during this auction someone is buying this art. So in every step the people are trying to increase the price to make the profit. So the gallery or the art agent or whoever is buying your art for a lower price, selling it for a higher price, reselling it for a higher price, and then it is going to an art buyer. But this art buyer is also seeing your art as a kind of investment. So at one point he will resell this art back to the cycle, back to an auction, and it's going again round and round. And in every step people are trying to increase the value to profit from buying and selling. This is the easiest way. It's called art flipping actually. And many artists are really astonished how fast the prices can increase, and they can only increase because there's enough value to sell and resell to increase the circle of profit. So the whole situation about pricing your art is to perhaps you are not right there in the secondary market, but preparing the value of your art and make it easy to understand to which prices it is connected. So to make a living just by selling art cheap is very often the death kiss for your further art career. So it is a process to really think it through. But nevertheless, telling you all this, don't worry so much about this. Nevertheless, the most important thing about you as an artist is that you are surviving as an artist and that you can still do art. So even with the first approach that I have shown you with the your expenses through the amount of artworks that you are producing and multiplied with your probability of selling art, it is the best approach, because then you will actually survive as an artist and you are able to use all these potentials that you are having and this outstanding creativity. And in one day there will be a possibility where you can participate in all this art market. But when you are not able to survive as an artist, then you don't have a chance to take part in this great creation. And the values of art, the cultural values of art, are so much higher that everything the art market and with this buying and selling can offer to you. It is a kind of business. Of course, it is bringing a lot of money and a lot of profit, and then you have more resources for your art. But nevertheless, this market is nothing without really the artistic cultural values of an artist, and you are the only person who can actually keep this whole system alive. This system without the artist is worth actually nothing. So keep your mind on surviving as an artist and producing more art. This is more important than any price you can put on your artwork and how much you can profit. I hope you are finding this interesting. It is an insight. There are of course many different ways of pricing your art, but if you like, sit down today and think about it. Think about it first. How can you structure your prices so you will survive and thrive as an artist? But also think about it when you will proceed in your artistic career and your prices will increase up to 40%, will your art be worth it when the prices are higher? What can you do to make your values of your art stand out even more, so the people in the market that are buying and reselling your art are seeing the profit and the values you have to offer? I hope this was interesting, and I hope to see you in my next video. Until then, see you soon. Bye bye.